says the Chinese have reached out and have sought to re-engage on trade talks and feeds the narrative that there's some optimism here, maybe we'll get a deal.
I have great respect for it. This is a very positive development for the world.
And predictably, the markets open and they're buoyant, as if this talk of decoupling and more trade war, for at least a day, we can forget about that and just buy stock.
I'm Sifton, founding editor of NYT Cooking, and figure out how to make that
of the G7. What's the response to all this up and down at the G7 from those leaders?
Well, you know, ever since Trump came into office, world leaders have spent a lot of time puzzling over what the real policies are from this White House. They've parsed through these often contradictory statements, contradictory actions. Amongst world leaders, the sense has been that on trade, Trump is serious about trying to contain China. Trump is serious about his view that the U.S. is being somehow fleeced in the global economy, which runs contrary to what just about every mainstream economist thinks. But Trump really does seem to think that, you know, if the U.S. is buying more stuff from a country than it's selling, that's a sign that it's getting ripped off, and that's certainly the case with China. But, you know, all of that said, the G7 leaders were pretty quiet. There was very little criticism for Trump's positions. I mean, there was this very tepid statement from the new British Prime Minister, Boris Johnson. Carried away, let's be careful that we don't do any damage to the world economy. Beyond that, the other G7 leaders were primarily in listening mode.
And here, why do you think that is? Why are they so reluctant to criticize?
China is a complicated question for the rest of the world, and especially for Europe, where there's a sense that they may not like the means that Trump is employing to try to readjust this relationship. But they do share the sense that China presents a really profound challenge to the modern global economy. So there is a shared sense, even if there's tremendous dispute over the chosen means, that it is time for a confrontation with China.
There's a version of this where the other G7 countries are being hurt by this trade war, but on some level they welcome the U.S. confronting China over its trade policy. Maybe because the U.S. is the only country, given its scale, that can actually do that.
Yeah, I wouldn't go that far. They would much prefer a collective effort, and in fact, they're very worried that one of the primary dangers of Trump's trade policy is he's dramatically undermined the concept of a rules-based trading system. He's completely bypassed the World Trade Organization, which is supposed to be the referee for trade disputes. But there is a general sense that at least...
Hey, Susie! Susie, come here. Susie, come. Susie! Susie, touch. Susie! Susie, touch! Susie, touch! Girl friendly. Is he friendly? Is he friendly? Okay. What's that? Beautiful. Hey, Susie! Susie! What's his name? Hey, Romeo. Susie. Thank you.
He's in love with Chloe.
Hi, Romeo.
And now she's 15 and it still works. She still got it.
Oh my God, he's beautiful. What kind of dog is he? A what? 18? What is he? What did he, what kind of dog is that? Oh, really? I've never seen that.
The,
oh, yeah, that's what it looks like. Oh, really? Oh, really?
You don't have to.
He's gorgeous.